Now you might remember what we used to call multitasking on the iPad, slide over, split view. It worked, but kinda not really. It always felt awkward, unnatural, and honestly, just a little bit broken. But now we've got something that finally makes sense. In iPadOS 26, multitasking is getting a real upgrade. We're talking about windowed apps, resizable, stackable, snap to the side, move off to the screen, bring it back with a tap, and you're even getting those little traffic control signals straight from the Mac. It's like chef's kiss. And just like that, multitasking is not multitasking anymore. It's using your iPad exactly the way that you want to do it. Now, if you like that, I've got seven more ways iPadOS 26 is making your iPad feel like it's broken. Let's get started. Now, before iPadOS 26, app controls, they are just a hot mess. Every developer had their own layout. Buttons are hidden in menus, long presses over here, short presses over there, and gestures, well, you didn't even know that they existed. There was no real pattern. It was just trial and error trying to figure out where you could find the menus. Is there a pop-up that appears? Maybe if you're the iPad whisperer, who knows? Well, that is gone. In iPadOS 26, Apple's bringing Mac-style menu bars to the iPad. Just a small swipe down from the top, and boom, there is the full menu bar right where you would expect it. You get File, Edit, View, and you can even press Command plus Comma to jump directly into the Settings pane. Talk about hot. It is clean, consistent, and for the very first time, it actually feels like your iPad knows what app you're in and actually gives you the tools to use it. Okay, now this next one, it is super sneaky.
I am
because
better
at first,
sneaky, sir.
You almost do not notice what has changed, but I want you to try this. Swipe up slowly using the trackpad and hold it just for a second. Not too long, just for a beat, and look at what you get. Instead of the flat car view that we've had forever, essentially, you now get a true bird's eye view of your apps. It shows the actual size of each window, where they are, what's in them, not just the last frame with what's frozen inside of them. It's like mission control, but on an iPad. It is not flashy, it's not loud, but once you see it, you can't go back. Never going back to iPadOS 18, never. You just can't go back. And if you're into this type of iPad content, the real features, the hidden tools, and the stuff that actually helps you work smarter, go ahead and hit subscribe. I've got more iPadOS 26 deep dives coming, and I promise it only gets better from here. All right, let's keep going. Next, the Files app has finally grown up because before this update, it felt like just like a knockoff of Finder on the Mac. Really, there was no columns, no previews, no real customizations. It looked like a file manager, but it really never even worked like one. It's like that one friend or that little brother who always wants to hang out with you. It just never worked that way. Well, now column view is much improved. You can resize each panel just like you can on the Mac. If you want to add a custom folder icon, well, long press on the folder, hit customize and select your favorite emoji. Or you can even color code it with tags. I know, tags are actually part of the workflow now. And one of my favorite little touches, you can drag folders from files straight into the dock. They stay there, you get quick access, zero friction for your workflow. And with that, it feels like the Files app is finally a real file manager, not a placeholder. And that leads me to my next pain point, which is apps. For years, we've been opening up files on the iPad the way that Apple wants us to. PDF, they open up in Safari. Image, that's gonna go to Photos. Documents, I guess it goes to Pages. But now we have the power to choose because in iPadOS 26, you can finally select the default app by file type. To do this, you long press on the file to select the default app to use. So if you've got multiple editing apps installed on your iPad, you are not locked into one. It is a small change, but it's the type of control users like you and me have been begging for a very long time. And this makes the iPad feel much less like a locked in box. I'm happy about it. Now, if you're like me, you've probably picked up your iPad only to find it dead, but you swear that you just recently charged it. Well, say goodbye to Sherlocking your way to finding the culprit because whenever you open up the battery settings in iPadOS 26, the battery section gives you the full picture, one that you're not actually gonna spend a lot of time looking for the culprit. You can see the charge level over time when you last plugged it in, how full it got, and how fast it drained. Scroll down, you'll get a proper list of apps ranked by battery usage. Tap into any one of them, get a full detailed breakdown of screen time, background activity, everything that you need to know to find the one that's draining your battery quickly. And yeah, the system now gives you recommendations to help improve battery life. Now it's not flashy, but it's the kind of visibility that users, we should have had this all along. Why is it taking so long? iPadOS 26. Now this next one here, this is for the nerds. I gotta take care of my peeps, the creators, the multitaskers, the people out there who are pushing their iPad, because in iPadOS 26, trying to control your audio source was like Madison Avenue. It was a one-way street. You wanna plug in a mic, everything routes to it. Connect your headphones, the app follows that. It wasn't very intuitive, but now you can route your audio on a per app basis, which means FaceTime is gonna appear in your earbuds if you wanted to, while your background music plays out loud. You can record in another app while monitoring another.
All right, guys, right now I'm talking to you on the front-facing camera of my iPad mini, and you should be hearing the internal microphone from the iPad mini. Doesn't sound bad. The room's a little, you know, a little echoey, but let's go ahead and switch over the mic, and I'm gonna do that by swiping down from Control Center. I'm gonna click on the mic controls, and I'm gonna change from iPad input to wireless microphone. And you should be able to hear the difference. You're hearing this mic right here. So I think it sounds good. This is a feature that I would love to use during FaceTime calls, during regular video calls, where I need that elevated presence during that. But let me know what you think and whether or not you will use this feature once it comes out in iPadOS 26.
This is the type of audio control that makes your iPad feel way more like a Mac, and you're gonna love it. Now, here's something that most people won't even notice, but this one is probably gonna go down as one of my top three features in iPadOS 26. Using your iPad to record in clean footage was a mess. If you wanted to do screen recording, which was not even gonna be the highest quality, you couldn't choose the audio source that you wanted. So if you were on a Zoom call, or maybe you were recording a podcast with a friend, you had to jump through a lot of hoops, and they all had varying degrees of success. But now you can record audio and video on your side, have the files saved locally, as well as have the other parties who you're collaborating with save their files to a shared folder. This means smoother playback, cleaner visuals, better auto handling, and no more hacks. So if you make tutorials, review apps, or even just want to share crisp walkthroughs using your iPad, this is a massive upgrade. It's quiet and it is powerful. And that is the list, 8 features that made me look at my iPad and think, man, how did I ever live without this? iPadOS 26 doesn't just reinvent the iPad, it just fixes the parts that always felt off, the parts that were worked around, the parts that we got used to, or the parts that we just stopped noticing. But now they're just better. It all feels like new again. Now, the great thing is that this is just the beginning of iPadOS 26. And if this video helped you, wait until you see what happens when you actually build your setup around iPadOS 26. I've got full workflows, deep dives, app picks on the way. So make sure you click subscribe and turn on notifications. My name is Mike. Guys, I will catch you in the next one.